Hi, AT from CNC at Home. SainSmart has asked me to review the Jinsoku LC-50 laser by Genmitsu. Let's quickly review the specifications. The LC-50 sports a powerful 10-watt compressed FAC diode laser for more focused power and better cutting ability. The 10-watt compressed FAC laser claims a 0.08 by 0.05 millimeter ultra-fine compressed spot that ensures high accuracy. It is belt-driven with an impressive maximum speed of 20,000 millimeters per minute. The integrated X and Y axis tensioner makes belt adjustments easy and helps improve accuracy. The LC-50 Plus comes with integrated air assist for cleaner cuts. The working area is 500 millimeters by 400 millimeters. It has a height of 75 millimeters that extends by 35 millimeters when the included raised foot pads are installed. There are several integrated safety features: E-stop switch, X and Y limit switches, protection shield. The LC-50 ships partially assembled with all aluminum construction. I'll be testing the cutting and engraving ability of the LC-50 on several types of material: glass, metal, fabric, wood, and more. I will be using light burn for all of my testing. Let's get over to the laser and see how it performs. We're going to start with some simple black card stock. It's approximately 0.47 millimeters thick. The LC-50 Plus made short work of this burn and did a really good job getting through the cardstock and doing our letters. So cardstock, no problem. Our next material is just going to be a slightly thicker cardstock. We're going to do some engraving on the top and then cut some puzzle pieces and see how that turns out. It would have helped if I looked at my puzzle template a little closer before I burned it. I'll do that on the next time I do a puzzle. Again, the LC-50 Plus made short work of burning through the cardstock, did a great job. Nice clean edges. I like having the air assist for that. The next is going to be some etching food. This is a thin mint, and it's just, I'm going to have it do some melting in, see how that works. Looks like the LC-50 Plus has absolutely no problem doing some engraving on a thin mint. Our next material is going to be some white polyester. I'm going to try and cut through this. And as expected, because it's white, the laser energy isn't really absorbed into the material, and it didn't cut through. So for this stocking, I'm going to go to plan B and on the back side, cut all the way through the material, cut some letters, pull those out, and then glue them to the front on that white fuzzy polyester. The LC-50 Plus didn't have any issue with this blue polyester, I'm assuming. And then I just used a piece of masking tape on top of what I had cut out, and then I was able to pull all of those pieces out so that they were in order and aligned still. Once I had all that out, I just put a little bit of white glue on the back of those and adhered them to the front. Worked pretty well. Our next material is going to be etching glass. I tried a new process where I put a piece of black material behind the glass and worked great where the glass was touching the black material. Where there was a gap, it didn't work as well. So you can see on the left-hand side, it's really light, and that was after two passes on that left side. I went back to using the tried and true method of actually painting the back of the glass black. That worked really great. We'll see here the etching of the glass almost brought on a silver quality to the glass, and contrasted against the black, that looked really cool. I ended up not cleaning the paint off the back because I liked the way that this looked with the black. But I could easily just clean that off like I have in the past if I wanted just the etched glass. Next, we're going to see if the LC50 can cut through some black acrylic. I used some settings from another laser that I have and tried cutting through and didn't get all the way through. So I tried another set of parameters. And that also didn't get through. So I kept slowing the laser down until I got to a point where it would cut all the way through this 2.5 millimeter black acrylic. I knew it would do it, I just had to find the correct speed. You can see the smoke getting sucked down with that downdraft ventilation, and we finally, looks like we're getting close to getting all the way through. Now that we've gotten our cutting parameters, let's cut a circle off of or out of this acrylic and see what kind of edge we get. I was able to get that piece out very easily, so we can cut acrylic nicely. For our next material, I'm going to do some etching on slate. I had several coasters that I was making, and they turned out fantastic. This is a picture. This is just filled in text. Here again, I took an image and converted it to vectors and filled it in. This is another image that I was able to burn on there. This is vectors that are filled in. And finally, another picture that I was able to burn on there. They all turned out really nicely, super easy to do. I'm going to do more slate. The LC50 did a great job. Now I'm going to try and cut through some 3 millimeter plywood. I've had this box template for a while that I got off of line somewhere, or got online somewhere, and now that I've got a more powerful laser that has a big enough area, I wanted to see if I could cut this out. I was able to get it to cut out, got it painted up, glued together, and the joints fit really nicely. The quality turned out nice, so the LC50 Plus did a great job cutting through 3 millimeter plywood. Now I'm going to do some etching on stainless steel. I had my doubts, as I really didn't think this was going to work. I was nervous about using the laser on this really shiny material. And once it was done, it actually etched on there. I was kind of set back, but I was pleasantly surprised. So I did a few more etching tests to see if I could fine-tune the parameters, and at 300 millimeters per minute at 80% seemed like a really good setting. My next test was to actually do something more than just basic letters. I wanted to do some filling, but not completely filling. I used a crosshatch method where it does diagonal lines and then another set of diagonal lines that are at a 90 degree angle to that for my fill. It goes a little bit faster. What we ran into on this particular burn is the heat of the laser was heating up the stainless steel to a point where it started to bend it, or what's referred to as oil canning. So it was adding and removing some stresses and tension within the material, and caused it to bend up, and eventually enough where it actually was hitting the laser emitter and moved our material around. So you'll see that here in a second. As it comes around, that right-hand side is so far up, and then it catches right about here and really moved it. So when I came back to outline my text and my image around the cross-hatching, you can see that it moved a lot. The engraving part worked really well, so it was not an issue with the LC-50 Plus, it was just my coating. The next thing I wanted to do is use the rotary roller. I had added the extension feet onto the LC-50 Plus, and it just wasn't enough. It didn't get everything high enough. So I put some more blocks under the feet to get it up high, and then started doing some actual cutouts and etching on some cardboard tubes. Both experiments ended up working pretty well. I was able to etch on the white cardboard, cardstock kind of stuff. I was able to cut through it relatively easy. And the end product was kind of what you would expect from cutting cardstock. And the nice thing was, this is the same rotary roller that I've used with the LE5040. So it's completely compatible with the LC50 Plus. So I end up with a nice dark image here for the etching. And we'll just get this to roll over to where we did the cutout, and you'll see that it was able to cut out as well. I didn't have any weight in the tube, so it did slip a little bit. Something to keep in mind when you're using a rotary roller, you have to keep your material weight down. Our next material I'm going to etch is some leather. I have some leather gloves that I wanted to put a little decoration on. In a prior video, I labeled the other glove with the word left. This one I labeled with the word right. Also put a couple little images on it. We'll zoom in here, and you can see the detail on the leather turned out really nicely. So the LC50 Plus did a great job on etching leather. An assumption that I made with the LC50 Plus was that the air assist pump would automatically come on when the controller told it to. And so what I want to do is run an experiment here to see if that happens. I'm going to do a fake burn at really low power and tell it to do with and without air assist, and we'll see if that pump comes on. So the first thing will be without the air assist. We'll see what happens. Okay, I have the air assist turned off, yet the pump did come on. When I stop the program, the pump does shut off. I've turned the air assist on within light burn. And again, it comes on when we start the burn. Let's get a little closer, you can hear that. I stop the burn, and then the pump does shut off. So apparently with this, you always get air assist. I'll do a little bit of looking to see if the right code is being sent. My assumption is that we're just going to always get the air assist. I did some more testing with the air assist, and I was able to send an M8, which is to turn it on, and an M9 to turn it off. And that did turn it on and off. I'm not sure if there is some sort of setting within light burn that it's not picking up or that I need to set. I haven't found anything yet. I did send a question out to both the laser manufacturer and to light burn to see if we can get this sorted out. If I don't want to have air assist on, I'd like to not have to unplug the power from it just to get that to happen. I'd also like to, if I want air assist, to not have to remember to plug it back in, which I do frequently because currently that is how I turn air assist on and off. It's not through the controller board, it's through me physically turning it on and off, and I'd like to remedy that. That being said, I think it's a cool feature. What I might do is hook a relay up or something to that 12 volt output from the controller board, and so I can get that connected to my 120 volt pump that I'm currently using and essentially use that as an on-off switch. Shouldn't be too difficult to do. I'll do some research into that. As a quick review for this laser, we cut several different kinds of materials with it. We etched on some material. Overall, it performed really well. The only thing that really kind of gets me every time I do it, if I don't have the laser shield protection, it's kind of a red plastic protection flipped down, and I run a homing cycle, that plastic shield will run into the front of the frame before the limit switch is hit, and that's not a good thing on the stepper motors. I have gotten to test the emergency stop button a few times because of that. It's important to remember to have that shield down, otherwise it can run into the frame itself. Other than that, I've been very impressed with this machine. The speed of these stepper motors is rated at 20,000 millimeters per minute. Unfortunately, the GRBL operating system that runs the controller won't allow me to set the 20,000 in there. I don't know if there's a hack to do that. At any time I try to set a number above about 15,200 or 16,200, depending on which axis, it comes back and says that that's an unacceptable value. So I cannot currently run this at 20,000, which is fine. I would never run it that fast anyway. It is kind of cool to see the movement of the gantry when it's up at that speed. The performance of the laser itself has been pretty good. The focusing is relatively easy to do. It locks in nice and tight, so the laser emitter itself doesn't seem to slide up and down once you've locked it in place. The cutting and etching has been pretty good. I would always like it to be more powerful or have the laser dot more focused. It is what it is, and it does a great job for that. So like I said, all in all, it was easy to assemble, easy to set up, and I really had a lot of fun doing testing on this. All the material burned well. Glass etching, cutting material, or the actual fabric material, cutting wood, cardboard. Other than my own mistakes in the programs that I've sent, what it's done has been really good. So my review is definitely two thumbs up for this machine. It's something that you could use as your first laser. It's a little bit physically bigger than the LE5040. The working area is the same as the LE5040. The laser is definitely more powerful. It has some nicer features built in and would be a good starting or even intermediate to advanced machine. I think it has some good growth potential for us here at CNC at home. I hope you liked this video. Give it a thumbs up if you did, and if you like the content of our videos, think about subscribing. That really helps us out. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.